My name is Jeanette Higgins, and I'm a volunteer with the Noonan Coweta Humane Society. And what our group does is we come down here to Coweta County Animal Control, located off of Selt Road, because we actually do not have our own shelter. I just want to make a little public service announcement real quick. Our group, NCHS, does not have its own shelter. We just come down here to Animal Control to try to showcase as many animals as we can. But we are in the need definitely for our own place, our own shelter, and would love to have that in the future. If you know anybody that would like to donate some property, that would be fabulous. But anyway, what we do is we come down here to Coweta County Animal Control, and we showcase as many of the fur kids and fur babies, as we like to call them, that we can get on the show in this segment, in hopes that someone out there will absolutely fall in love and want to rush on down and adopt a pet. So stay tuned, and we hope that you enjoy the show. To get this girl out, she just would not have it if we didn't get her out. So I'm putting my hand here because she's ready to jump and play. She's purring up a storm. She was pawing at her cage door, wanting to come out so badly. This is Gloria, and I tell you what, she is glorious. She is so soft and so sweet, very, very affectionate, and very rare, actually, because most orange tabbies are male, and she's female, so she is extra, extra special. But what a darling. Oh my goodness. If you are looking for a cat that is highly affectionate and will just sit in your lap, but also has that fun, curious side like definitely Gloria has, you'll want to come on down here and adopt this girl. Right now she is hanging out in C1. That's her cat condo number. She was picked up as a stray from Glover Circle. No ID of any sort on her, so she is up for adoption now since mom and dad have not found her. Her first family has not come back and found her. She is up for adoption now, and she's been here since the beginning of February, and here we are at the beginning of March, so she is definitely ready to go to a home. And look at her now, she's just settling into my lap. She is absolutely wonderful. So like I said, if you're looking for a highly affectionate cat that will just love on you and be the best friend you've ever had, then definitely come on down and rescue Gloria. A very excited fella to be on the show this morning. This is Shane, and he, believe it or not, he was calm as can be out in the yard before Ann brought him in here. But once he got in here and he got all this attention and we're all just excited to see him and he got all caught up in this excitement, he just started talking away and telling us all about his story and just hanging out and getting all wound up. So you're seeing his happy, excited side for sure. But Shane here is a Chihuahua mix. He is black and gray, and this happy little guy is still a puppy, so that makes sense why he would be so excited. They're showing he's about 8 months old, but certainly the vet here at Animal Control can verify that. Looks like he is in A5, he's heartworm negative, he's had his shots, he's been dewormed, and as you can see, he is good to go. Now, he came into Animal Control, I believe, wearing the green collar that he has on now. He's got a blue one on too, but I think this kind of aqua, I can't really turn his head too well, this aqua turquoisey green collar is what he came in with. So we know that he was somebody's pet, and he just got out, and he just went for a run and got lost and appeared in Animal Control. So we're hoping his family will come pick him up, but if not, you know, he is available for adoption right now, so you can certainly come get him yourself if you want to come get this happy-go-lucky boy. So come on down and rescue Shane. This little guy here is just waiting for you. Also, now we are presenting you with an orange tabby male. This handsome fella is Calvin, and I tell you what, he is just wonderful. He is loving all over our volunteer Claudia here, and Calvin was just headbutting her with his head, and he's doing the making the biscuits thing that they love to do when they feel so happy. They just spread out their paws and just start kneading the dough kind of thing. He's just a very, very, very happy cat right now. But Calvin here is, he is right at a year old, and this handsome fella is hanging out in C30. That's his cat condo number. He was picked up as a stray from Gibson Road, and he has come a long way, because I tell you what, when he first came into animal control, he was so afraid they could hardly even hold him. But now that he knows that nobody's gonna hurt him, and you know, we're really just loving on him and trying to help him out, then he has just blossomed into this wonderful, affectionate, sweet, sweet guy. And I tell you what, he has the sweetest eyes. I mean, his eyes just look so innocent and sweet. They're the gorgeous color of his fur, that gold color. And I tell you what, you can just see by the way he's acting with Claudia that you are going to get somebody special when you get this boy. So if you're interested in Calvin, please do hurry on down to animal control and rescue this boy. And I tell you what, they say that dogs are a man's best friend, but I think cats can be anybody's best friend too. So come on down and get Calvin. Folks, we have a very, very special girl here. This is Liliana, and she was actually nicknamed after our volunteer Anne here's niece, who her niece just had a birthday. So we are naming Liliana here after Anne's niece. Now, this dog is absolutely terrified, folks. I mean, she was very well cared for. Her nails are trimmed. She looks very healthy. She doesn't have any scars or anything like that that make us think that anybody was mean to her, but she is just absolutely terrified being here at animal control. So Liliana is in B15, and this precious girl was picked up as a stray from Preserve Drive wearing a pink collar. So we know that she did belong to someone. And like I said, she's very full. You know, she's not thin. She looks like somebody's taking care of her, and she's just in great shape. But my goodness, this poor girl is so out of sorts and so scared being here at animal control. Now, it looks like she's heartworm negative. She's had her shots while she's been here. I'm not sure of her age. I'm sure she's at least a year old. She's a terrier mix and just a gorgeous, gorgeous girl. But, you know, here it is, the beginning of March, and no one has come back to reclaim her as far as her original owners. So she is up for adoption now. But goodness, folks, she does not need to be here. She is so, so scared. I'm sure being back in the kennel with all those dogs, and it's so loud, and she's done nothing wrong except obviously got out and got lost and ended up here at animal control. So if you're interested in Liliana, please hurry on down. I tell you what, you can just tell by this girl that she is so gentle and so sweet, has a heart of gold, and she will just fill your home with a lifetime of love. So come on down and rescue Liliana. She's down here just waiting to be your new best friend. This handsome fella is Mufasa. And I tell you what, if you have never owned a Maine Coon, you need to come down here and adopt this boy, because they are some of the sweetest, most affectionate cats that you could ever possibly own. And they are large cats, but they are big, and they have a big, big heart inside that big body. And they, like I said, they can just be the most incredibly affectionate cats you could ever own. Now, Mufasa is about 3 years old. He is in C29. That's his cat condo number. And this handsome fella was picked up in the Sargent community. No collar, no ID of any sort. And he is just so ready to go, folks. He has been here since the end of January, and we are at the beginning of March. And poor Mufasa is just trying to be as patient as he can possibly be, but he doesn't want to be here at animal control. He wants to be in somebody's home where he can love on you and get lots of love back. And oh my goodness, he is such a handsome fella. I tell you what, he would just, you know, if you're looking for a little curb appeal for your home, just put this handsome fella in the window. And I tell you what, people will be stopping just to see that cat, because they would swear he's some kind of little bobcat or something. I mean, he is just so handsome. So come on down and rescue Mufasa, because I tell you what, this handsome fella is just waiting for you to come and give him a better life And I tell you what, you just don't even know. He's going to improve your life as well. So come on down and rescue Mufasa. Chihuahua Mix, he is very, very scared as well as some of the other dogs here. I was just giving him a bunch of little mini milk bones and he was just scooping them up, but now he's gotten all nervous again. He's a very sweet boy. He's just scared. I mean, who can blame this guy? He's only been here since the end of February. It's the beginning of March. But we don't want to see Colin here one more day, folks, because he's a very, very sweet boy. He's hanging out in A1. He's still very young. He's only about 2 years old. And he was picked up from the South Oaks Mobile Home Park wearing a camouflage-type collar. So we know he was somebody's pet, and he just got lost. And he really just needs to find his way home. So if you are interested in Colin, please come down here to Animal Control. He is available for adoption now, and we just want to make sure that he doesn't have to spend a lot of time here because he is so, so scared. And we want him to feel safe and secure in somebody's home and get some good nutrition and lots of love. And I tell you what, when you adopt a shelter pet, you are saving their life, but you are changing their life. And I tell you what, they will change your life as well. So come on down and adopt Colin.
Oh, I get cozy. It's okay. The dogs can come in.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And folks, this handsome fella is Paul, and I could hear him purring as soon as Claudia took him out of his cage. He is a loud, loud purr, but a very, very affectionate boy, as you can see. He is loving the attention he's getting from her volunteer, Claudia. Now, Paul is about 7 or 8 months old, and he is hanging out in C31. So he's one of our black and white cow kitties, as we like to call them, because they look like the dairy cows with their black and white fur. But the vet here at Animal Control believes and knows that he is so sweet that she marks sweet on his card. And she doesn't do that for every dog or cat. So we know that Paul here is extra, extra sweet. And he is just having a moment with Claudia here. I tell you what, it is a love connection for sure. But I tell you what, folks, he is just a highly affectionate boy. And he will give you that same kind of love and attention that he's giving our volunteer, Claudia. So if you're interested in Paul, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control. Like I said, he's been here since the middle of January. And they have not put out a euthanasia list here at Animal Control in quite a while. But we certainly don't want any of these animals to end up on that list should they be here just a little bit too long. So let's not let that happen to Paul. He needs a home just like everybody else here. And I tell you what, he is going to give you a lifetime of love for sure. So come on down and rescue Paul. As a little girl, I always hoped that my teddy bear would somehow come alive and I would be able to play with it as a live teddy bear. This is like a live teddy bear. This girl, Natalie, is so fluffy and so sweet. And oh my gosh, if you can see this little tail over here, it is just a wagging like crazy. She was so calm in the yard, and then I came out there and I was like, hey, cutie. And the higher my voice goes, the higher pitched it is, the more these dogs get wound up. And she just started just all over the yard, just running and playing and just, oh my goodness, she is just precious. I love how fluffy she is. What a gorgeous, gorgeous girl. Now, I believe that she is still a puppy, which explains some of her higher energy, but she's about 10 months old, so she's almost about to turn a year. She is a Chow Chow mix. And Natalie here is hanging out in B10, that's her kennel number. She was picked up as a stray from Poplar Road. No collar, no ID, no microchip, none of that stuff. Oh, well, yeah, actually, Anne was just reminding me, the only ID we have is the fact that she did come in with this pink nylon collar. So we know she was somebody's pet. It's one of those really nice top paw collars that you get at PetSmart that, you know, it's a nice, nice collar, but no tags. Folks, you have to microchip your pet because those tags that are on that collar can easily get hung up on something and get broken off, or somebody can take them off. They can take off the collar of your pet. But if an adult dog shows up at a vet's office and you say it's yours, they have to scan it to see if there's a chip because they want to make sure it was not stolen from somebody's yard or that it doesn't have a prior owner. So really, the microchipping works. And it's for life. You pay that, you know, $20 to $40 fee one time to get the microchip, and it's there for life. So anyway, off my soapbox, but Natalie here is heartworm negative. She's had her shot. She's been dewormed. And like I said, if you are looking for a real life teddy bear, then definitely this is the girl for you. You've got to come down and meet Natalie. I tell you what, she is super, super special. So come on down and rescue this girl, take her home, and she will give you a lifetime of love and be a wonderful, wonderful addition to your family. So come on down and rescue Natalie. And folks, we have a very scared girl here. This is Annabelle, and she was actually confiscated. She's part of a cruelty case. So we don't know what her story was prior to coming to animal control. We just know that right now she's just very, very scared, but she's a sweet girl. She's purring and she's calming down now, but she was just a little frightened when Claudia first got her out of her cage. She is in C2, that's her cat condo number. She is at least a year old, and she's another one of these cow kitties that we like to call them, that are the black and white kitties. She may not be used to being held much, because she's just not really sure if she wants to be held or not, but it could just be that she's just really scared, you know, being here at animal control with all the dogs barking in the kennel and all of that. And like I said, she was part of a cruelty case and was confiscated by animal control, so we don't know what her story was prior to coming here. So if you're interested in Annabelle and you want to show this girl that no one is going to hurt her and that she does deserve a lifetime of love, then come on down and rescue her. She really needs you, and she needs you now. So come on down and rescue Annabelle. And folks, we have a talker here, so if he starts telling us all about his day, I'm sorry, but he's a little guy with a loud voice. This is Biscuit. Well, butter my biscuit and call me a dog. I tell you what, this is a funny guy. He is in A9. He's about a year old. He's a Jack Russell Terrier, and this boy was picked up by a stray. I know you don't want to be here. I know you don't want to be here. If that doesn't break your heart, I don't know what will, folks, because that is one dog that is not wanting to be here and is very, very having a really hard time being here for sure. He was picked up as a stray from Bagley Road, had a green collar on, which he still has on. It's kind of a turquoise bluish green, but he is not wanting to be here a bit, folks. He's had his shots, he's been dewormed, he's heartworm negative, and Biscuit here just needs to go home. He doesn't need to be here one more day. He is one sweet, sweet boy that is so confused about being here at animal control. And, you know, he's scared, and I'm sure part of that sound that he's making is just because he wishes he could tell us what is going on, but he can't communicate with us, so he's going to bark, and he's going to make noise, and he's going to let us know what he's feeling, even though we don't understand it. So if you're interested in Biscuit, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control. As you can see, he is absolutely adorable, and we love him too, and he will be more than happy to talk your ear off and tell you all about his day. So come on down and rescue Biscuit, because this boy is waiting for you. Just I tell you what, this is one sneaky girl. I can figure out how in the world she became a stray, because she, well actually, honestly, she was confiscated. I just noticed that on her card. She scooted out of here and into the dining room area or the snack lunchroom area or whatever here at Animal Control. She was going to find herself a snack, and she was going to find it now. But this is Michelle. She is a gorgeous, gorgeous black kitty. She is hanging out in C6, and she's at least a year old. And like I said, she was confiscated as part of an eviction process. So folks, I tell you what, you know, whether it's an eviction situation or a confiscation, you know, confiscated type situation, or even just a death in the family where they leave pets behind, you've got to remember to have an action plan for your pets should something happen to you. It's a good idea, if you have a will, to go ahead and will your pets to somebody and let that person know that you're willing them, that your pets to them, because, you know, something can happen to us and we need somebody to take care of our pets, and we want to know that our pets that are left behind are going to be taken care of. So just want to, you know, throw that out there for people to just think about. But Michelle here, like I said, is just absolutely gorgeous. Big gold eyes. I mean, her eyes are just beautiful. And nice jet black silky fur. She's a very pretty girl. And like I said, a little bit of an escape artist. So you have to keep your eye out for this one for sure. But sweet as she can be, soft and wonderful. and would just make a wonderful addition to anybody's home. So if you're interested in Michelle, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control and give this precious, precious girl a forever home. And folks, this is Gigi, and this girl is just so full of energy, guys. She is a Siberian Husky mix. Gorgeous, gorgeous girl, at least a year old. She's hanging out in B14. She was picked up as a stray from Old Highway 85, and she's had her shot. She's been dewormed, heartworm negative, and she is just so ready to go to her new home, folks. And she is one of two, right? There's two. She's got a sister. There's actually two of these girls hanging out here at Animal Control that are looking to be adopted, and we are so surprised that they're still here because they are so, so sweet. I mean, as you can see, very well-mannered dogs. Gigi, when I was giving her a treat, sat right down without me even having to say sit. So somebody taught her how to sit, and just beautiful. I mean, they keep their fur nice and clean, considering the fact that, you know, they spend a lot of time running around in the yard and in their cage. And they, dogs don't groom themselves like cats do, and for her fur to be that clean, oh my goodness, and she loves belly rubs. Oh, wow. We are in hog heaven here at Animal Control for sure, folks. So if you're interested in Gigi or her sister, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control. As you can see, she's a wonderful dog, very well-mannered, very smart, and gorgeous to boot. So you are going to get yourself the perfect dog. So come on down and rescue Gigi. Great time here with this boy. This handsome fella is McGraw. And I tell you what, he is one big boy for sure. He's a gorgeous gray tabby. He is about a year old and he is hanging out in C5. That's his cat condo number. He was picked up as a stray from Mount Carmel. They scanned him, no microchip, no ID. And folks, yes, you can also microchip cats. It's not just for dogs. But look at how sweet he is. He is just a snuggler and a lover. He's definitely not a fighter. He's a lover. He's a big, big boy. I tell you what, you know, he's like the, you know, that My Pillow that you can sleep with, you can order on TV. He's like My Pillow cat version because you could just lay on this boy. He is just wonderful. So if you're looking for a big boy with a big heart, then definitely you want to come and rescue McGraw, because I tell you what, this big boy is just waiting to be a part of your family and fill your home with love and just be your best buddy. So come on down and rescue McGraw. Guys, that is our show for today. Thank you so very much for tuning in. If you'd like to find out what our group is doing in the community, please do visit our website at nchsrescue.org. And go ahead and like our Facebook page while you're at it. You can get information a little bit more quickly, and you can comment on things and question, you know, send in questions through our Facebook page. So go ahead and like that and start following that. But one event that we do have coming up that I want to make sure that I mention is on March 18th. That is the day after St. Patrick's Day. It is a Saturday, the 18th. We are having a fundraiser. We're calling it Happy St. Patrick's Day, and it's going to be at the Abide Brewing Company in Noonan. We're going to have lots of activities, not just for adults, but also fun stuff for kids. There's going to be music and food and just all kinds of fun. We're certainly going to have a doggy kissing booth, because that always goes over well and is always a lot of fun for kids as well as adults. But just lots of fun things that our group is going to be doing that day. So like I said, March the 18th, mark your calendars. Happy St. Patrick's Day at Abide Brewing Company. I believe it's going to be in the afternoon. I think it's from 1 to 6. If I'm not right on that, please make sure that you check our website and the Facebook page to get more information on that. But I just want to make sure that I mention it. So guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Want to make sure that we thank the Coweta County Animal Control Facility for allowing us to come down and showcase these wonderful pets that they have for adoption here. And what you see on the show is just a little smidgen of what's available here. There are hundreds of dogs and cats available for adoption here. So if you don't see what you like on the show, just come down and just look through their book up front or walk through the kennel and the cat rooms and take a look. And just come down here and play with them if you want to. Hey, it's a free fun day for the kids, and they can have some interaction with the pets, and it really helps the pets to be more highly adoptable when they spend more time with people. So thank you again for tuning in. Also want to make sure that I thank New Link for making this show possible, sending us Laura, the best camera woman in the U.S. and beyond. And also thank you to our wonderful volunteers for giving your time, love, and everything else to further our cause and try to make Coweta County a no homeless pets community. So thank you so much for tuning in. We hope that you enjoy the show, and we hope that you will catch us next time on Adopt a Pet.